Greetings, I am the cartoon hero. When I was in junior high, I read a book called Fahrenheit 451. It was an interesting read. Basically, it was about a dark future where all books are banned, and the term fireman now applies to a person who goes to find the banned knowledge and burn them, until one fireman discovers exactly what he's been burning and starts to question if his job is really the right one. The title, Fahrenheit 451, is supposedly the temperature at which books burn. At the time, though, I didn't really get it. In fact, it wasn't until after the author, Ray Bradbury, passed away recently that I went to take a look back at it and realized what a genius work of allegory it was. It's basically a cautionary tale of what happens when censorship goes too far, and what knowledge can do in the right hands. Or the wrong ones. And hell, nowadays it might be even more appropriate. I think now I might consider it one of my favorite books. However, this is Halloween, and today I'm talking about another Ray Bradbury story. Specifically, one of his short stories, The Halloween Tree. The Halloween Tree is the story of a group of kids that go on a mission to save their missing friend Pip on Halloween night. But in the process, they learn about the origins of their costumes, and of Halloween itself. It sounds interesting, but I haven't actually read the story. However, in 1993, Hanna-Barbera and Cartoon Network adapted the story into an animated TV movie of the same name, which apparently had the blessing of Ray Bradbury himself because he appears in the film. The movie would go on to win a Daytime Emmy for Outstanding Writing in an Animated Program, but then Cartoon Network would once again show their brilliant business skills by releasing the movie on VHS in 1994, with a second print in 1995, and we would have to wait until 2012 before the movie would get a proper DVD release. But is this movie a buried treat or a concealed trick? Let's find out as we unearth The Halloween Tree.